All right, we're back with Carla, and we're going to talk about why you would want to move to Sarasota or retire in Sarasota Lakewood Ranch. Driving up and down the same old strip. I gotta find a new place where the kids are hip. So we're going to talk about maybe some reasons why you'd want to move here, some of the selling points. And then at the end of this video, we're going to maybe mention a couple things that are reasons you wouldn't want to move here. Maybe the reason it wouldn't fit your lifestyle. I think first and foremost, what's the difference between Lakewood Ranch and Sarasota?
Well, Sarasota, you have the beaches, you have this outdoor area, beautiful water behind you, boating. Downtown, you have the Ringling Museum. That's a huge historical landmark. You have the opera, you have comedy centers. There's just always something to do. Sometimes they'll close off the streets and have just little festivals that are free to people.
So Sarasota is or Lakewood Ranch is completely separate. Both Manatee County?
Lakewood Ranch is separated. Half is Manatee County and part of it is Sarasota County.
In terms of the way we have it separated, it's sort of all one area. Just because if you're looking in this area, I'm sure the appeal to being in Lakewood Ranch is, one, the master plan community, but the fact that you're close to this, you're close to St. Pete, and you're close to Fort Myers and Englewood and a lot of the cool stuff on this coast.
Right. And mostly if you're trying to look for a house over here closer to the beach, it's not going to be the type of homes that we're looking at in Lakewood Ranch. Lakewood Ranch, you actually have the neighborhoods, the community pools. Over here, they're older style houses. They're probably built in the 1920s, 1950s. You need to remodel them or tear them down, build new. So there's a lot of difference in the type of homes. So
great time to say that Carla isn't just a 55 plus agent. She can sell any real estate in this area. She's a professional realtor.
Location wise, and then obviously a big draw to this would be probably beaches, yeah. Right? So if you could touch on beaches, what are the beaches like here and comparison to other places in Florida too? Because obviously we have plenty of beaches to choose from in the state.
Right. So I feel like on the Gulf Coast, I feel like the water's a little calmer, it's a little bluer. The beaches are a little more clean to me, like it's the white finer sand.
Yeah.
Siesta Key especially, it's a deep beach area, white fluffy sand. There's always free parking, so you never have to pay for parking unless the beaches are just so full because of a holiday or whatever. You can park at a local church and give them a donation and park in the...
When these don't seem, and I'm sure they do get busier for spring break, but these don't seem like the spring break beaches that people flock to either. Sarasota feels much more kind of like local snowbird.
It is definitely a local feel. You make friends, people want to live here, and there is that snowbird that happens too. So now's the time that everybody, so this is April, now's the time that people are starting to go back north if they're going to go back north.
Yeah.
The only negative to being on the beach, every now and then we will get red tide. So
yep.
That's kind of a strong smell. It only happens a few times a year.
Yep. You get that on all the Gulf Coast especially.
Yeah, you get that.
Just part of the beach living.
It is part of the beach living. Very eco-friendly area though. There's turtle clubs. The people go out. Specifically, you join a turtle club, you go out, you clean up the beach, you can go out on a boat and feed certain wildlife.
So just out of curiosity, if people's grandparents were here, how far is Disney?
It took us 2 hours to get there.
Not bad.
No.
No, especially if you're not gonna be going every weekend or something.
No.
Really anywhere in Florida, it's like you can still easily get to it.
The Sarasota airport's from where we're at here on Longboat Key, we're just another...
Sarasota International Airport?
Yes.
I'll be darned.
Yep.
I had no idea.
Sarasota International. Sarasota Bradenton. SRQ.
It's pretty easy to fly in and out.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
I personally fly out of St. Pete because it's a direct flight into West Virginia.
Okay.
And
St. Pete's right there too. And that's easy airport.
It is very easy. Actually, Sarasota's airport's really easy. It's a small airport. They're going to build a new terminal because it's just... you got several airports to choose from.
The other thing I like too is like we're at a nice restaurant on the water and people are in Hawaiian shirts, mm-hmm. flip-flops, bathing suits. It's like, it feels proper beach Florida. Yes. It's awesome.
And this is a high-end area we're in, but it's still very casual. People aren't snobby.
Which is cool.
Yeah. So we have the Legacy Trail that runs from downtown Sarasota to Venice.
Is that a biking trail?
It's a biking, walking, jogging, whatever. Nice. You can take your dogs. Every so often down the trail, there'll be like a little bike station. So if you have a flat tire, you can actually stop and fix your bike.
And that goes to Venice?
It goes to Venice. So I think it's 18.5 miles long. So you can go on bike. I have an electric bike, so I would probably use my electric bike to get there.
Just in case you get a leg cramp.
Yes. And along the Legacy Trail where I play pickleball, there's 12 new pickleball courts at Pompano Park. And then Venice does have a restaurant right on the water, which you don't see a whole lot of restaurants right on the beach. So there's one in Venice called Sharky's. And then if you go north here a little bit.
Sharky's.
Shark teeth. And then if you go north here, you have Bradenton Beach, so you have some restaurants.
Yeah. There is something to the fact that when you're on the Gulf side, it's more of a shallow sort of bowl on the way out, so you don't have the big waves and currents that you do on the East Coast. So older people can get in and out of the water easier than trying to fight some waves.
Yeah, you just kind of go out.
Your grandkids, you don't have to worry about too. So that's a nice part about this coast.
Yeah. So Sarasota does have really, really nice weather.
This little pocket gets a lot of sunshine. And it seems like the rain skips over.
It does.
A decent amount.
Like once you get a little south of Sarasota, you get a little bit more of the weather. Huh. So we're just like in our little bubble. This is a very safe city. Yeah. I feel very safe here.
Yeah. There's a little traffic going on, but of course there's a boat show and all this other stuff.
It's the weekend, it's in season. Yeah. I'm sure it's very seasonal here.
It is very seasonal, yes.
So you are gonna probably see that.
The cool thing is from the
Lakewood Ranch.
Lakewood Ranch area, it's easy access. When you wanna come down, you can pick and choose the times you come down too, right?
Lakewood Ranch it got busy as you started coming towards the beach. It felt pretty easy to get around Lakewood Ranch.
It is.
Oh, yeah.
And the only reason to really leave Lakewood Ranch would be to come to the beach or to go to a show in downtown Sarasota.
You're definitely paying for the lifestyle out here, because even in Lakewood Ranch and outside, it's, and this could be a good thing or a bad thing if you can afford it, it's more expensive.
Yes.
And again, of course, it depends upon the home style.
Right.
A small villa versus a home, and the location on the water or the golf course.
Right.
So there's a lot of variables.
Well, you can obviously get in for a lot less than that, but it's just
bottom line is, if your budget's under $400,000, it's slim pickings if you can find it.
If you're in $400,000 range, you might be able to get the same thing in Venice or Northport, just a little bit south of here.
And that's why you get a great agent like Carla, who knows what your options are.
All right, thank you. Thank you so much, Carla. If you guys have any questions, want more information, or are thinking about moving or retiring in Sarasota, Lakewood Ranch area, she's your gal. You can get connected with her directly on explore55plus.com. If you go through there and select Sarasota as the area you're interested in, she'll pop up. Or you can always give us a call, text us, email us, and we'll get you connected.
Thank you so much.
Thanks,
Explore.
Driving up and down the same old strip. I gotta find a new place where the kids are hip.